bilateral visit between the two countries since he took office. During a meeting with Prime Minister Justin Trudeau today, the two leaders are expected to dive into some of the most challenging issues facing the two countries. That includes climate change, mass migration, and national security. This comes as the two countries have reportedly reached a deal on a decades-old asylum agreement. NBC News White House correspondent Monica Alba joins us now from Ottawa with the latest. Monica, good morning. So let's start with this agreement over migrant crossings. This is something the Canadian Prime Minister has faced backlash over recently, but it does appear the two leaders have struck a deal. So talk to us about that and when we could expect an official announcement.
That's right, Joe. This was going to be one of the major pressure points of this meeting today, with President Biden, the First Lady, arriving late last night. And even before Air Force One touched down, we were able to confirm news that the U.S. and Canada are essentially going to hash out what has been very frustrating for Canada, according to Canadian officials. And this has to do with migrants who are trying to cross into Canada without authorization. So they're trying to come across the northern border in this section known as Roxham Road, which really goes into upstate New York. And now this new deal that we do expect to be announced after their extended bilateral meeting later this morning would essentially allow the U.S. and Canada to turn away some of those migrants who are coming over. And in exchange, Canada is then going to provide 15,000 slots for migrants to apply to try to come legally. So, of course, this has been a major discussion. Normally, when we're talking about this issue in the Western Hemisphere and the challenges it presents with the southern border, but they've really seen an uptick here in the northern border in Canada. So we knew this was going to be a major topic of conversation, and that's why the two governments essentially came to this agreement. But we're expecting to learn a lot more about some of the other details and how it would work and how it would be implemented as that meeting gets underway today.
Another major topic is national defense, top priority for both leaders after the now infamous Chinese spy balloon flew through both countries. At issue here is NORAD, which safeguards North America from attack. It does much, much, much more than track Santa around Christmas time. So can we expect any announcements about NORAD today?
Well, certainly Canada has said that it was going to pledge a large investment to modernize NORAD, but the U.S. says they would like to see that even stepped up further and to do more. Because remember, it was after the Chinese spy balloon that those aerial objects were shot down afterwards, with the U.S. coordinating closely with Canada, because some of that was shot down over the Yukon and then over Lake Huron. And remember, all of that was an incredibly tense moment where the U.S. wasn't even able to say what some of these objects were. So they're hoping that if they're able to modernize this technology, that can be a help. But also, this is really about the larger implications of the strategic competition with China. And we heard a little bit more from the Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau in an interview specifically about that point and priority for the two countries. Take a listen.
There are also areas in which we're going to have to directly challenge China, whether it's on human rights, whether it's on security behaviors, whether it's on cyber attacks or concerns like that. We are going to have to continue to be wide-eyed and clear about the threat that China poses and wants to pose to the stability of our democracies.
So plenty to discuss here. Of course, those are some of the most complicated issues, but the U.S. is stressing this is an incredibly important relationship. Certainly, this was the first phone call that President Biden made after he was sworn into office, but it is his first visit here as president.
All right, Joe. Monica Alba in Canada. Monica, thank you so much.
Thanks for watching our YouTube channel. Follow today's top stories and breaking news by downloading the NBC News app.